Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to our afternoon sermon or service, where Brother Lowell Fludd will be delivering the message this afternoon. My call of worship scripture is going to come from the book of 2 Timothy. And it's a scripture that we all know by heart. It's 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 15. And it starts out, it's going to start at, chapter 2, verses 1 to 3. Then I'm going to move over to verse 15. Amen. It starts out like this. Though therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ, and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also. Though therefore, endure hardness, as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. That being read, I move over to verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that neither not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Amen. Work for God's approval, not man's approval. Amen. Let's take it to our Heavenly Father this afternoon in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, as we come, dear Heavenly Father, knowing that we should work for you and for your approval, dear Heavenly Father, not of men, dear Heavenly Father. Studying your word, dear Heavenly Father, that we may be praised by you and that man, but also Heavenly Father, that we may stay strong in your grace and that we endure hardness, dear Heavenly Father, as a good soldier on the field for you, dear Heavenly Father. And dear Heavenly Father, as we go forth in the service, dear Heavenly Father, it's going to be a man that you have called, which are many are called, dear Heavenly Father, but few are chosen, dear Heavenly Father. So as he come, dear Heavenly Father, and thank you for choosing him, dear Heavenly Father, Lord Fludd, dear Heavenly Father. Touch him from his head to his feet, dear Heavenly Father. Anoint him, dear Heavenly Father. Move any doubt, any hesitation, dear Heavenly Father, as he go forward in this service, dear Heavenly Father. Dear Heavenly Father, the message that you have placed on his heart, dear Heavenly Father, come from on high. It's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
Go with me until we follow. Don't on go with me, I still we follow. Don't on go with me, I still we follow. No journey back, no journey back.
Don't
forget
me,
I saw this. My cross I carry to cross pay Jesus, not cross I carry. Just say Jesus, not turning back, turning back. Behind me, the cross before me, the wall behind me, the cross before me, no turning back, no turning back.
Because of, he's received God's amazing grace.
Yes.
Like Brother Lynn said, many a call, but not many answer the call. And he's decided to follow Jesus and answer that call.
To me, his word, my hope, secure.
like snow. The sun forbear to shine. My God, who called me here below, will be forever mine. Will be forever mine. You are forever mine.
Glory, glory, glory.
Say good evening to everyone again on this glorious occasion. I am due honor to introduce my dear brother in Christ, as a bio and can realize that he is truly a man who loves the Lord. It's all about God and the work of God. Dear brother, Lowell, Fludd. He's the last of five siblings, born in Albany, New York, to Kearney Sadler and Henry Fludd. His early schooling took place in Albany, New York, where he graduated Cardinal Muskinny High School. He went on to further his education, where he received an associate degree in Miami Muskinny College. He is currently a student of the Lanchester Bible College in Greenbelt, Maryland. And his main focus is on Bible study. But I would like you to know, before his calling, he has served as a Sunday school teacher, Sunday school superintendent, vacation Bible school director, recording secretary for the male choir, transportation coordinator, nursery coordinator, men's day coordinator. You have a lot under your belt.
Bless you.
Says he has been recruited as the MC to make presentation and narrate plays and special events. He said, in addition, he provides hands-on assistance to the trustee ministry when needed. He said he loved the outreach ministry. He said he served at the Mount Bethel Baptist Association, a quarterly lesson presenter, and a quarterly meeting chairperson. As the Mount Bethel Sunday School Auxiliary Vice President. He said, basically, my ministry objective is to give God glory, while helping people to grow in the love for God and serve others. sense of God. With any further ado, I present to you my dear brother, who I believe has a calling on his life to do the will of God. I pray that your hearts and your mind will be open to hear from him as the Lord continue to speak to him. I will let him introduce his guest and family member, so I wouldn't mess up the order in which he has it. So let us put our hands together and welcome our dear brother as he stands to proclaim the word of God. Hear him, hear him, hear him. Let us put our hands together.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord together. Amen. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not get weary. They shall walk and not faint. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. His name shall continuously be in my mouth. We come here today praising his holy and righteous name. We praise God for from whom all blessings flow. We praise God, all creatures here below. Praise them above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I love to praise them. Do y'all love to praise them? Would y'all love to praise them? I love to praise him.
Out and supported. We had a hallelujah good time on yesterday, and it was a sight to behold. Let me say, it was a sight to behold. But I want to thank you all for coming out. You did not consider it robbery to come out and to share on this afternoon. I am thankful unto you for that. Carlton, good to see you. Good to see you, Carlton. I'd like to introduce my family. I have my grand. How many of us know that the glory of the aged are their children's children? The glory of the aged. I was once young, but now I'm old. But yet have I seen the righteous forsaken nor seed begging bread. And I want to thank God for certainly my three grandchildren out there. And of course, my daughters and my sister and my niece and her husband and the in-laws back there. I thank you all for showing up. Thank you all, for they traveled a distance. I have some that are in Maryland here, and then the others traveled from Richmond, Virginia. And so I'm thankful to see you all. It does make my heart smile. indulge me for a second as I go through some preliminaries. Just go through some preliminaries here. It is good to see my pastor. It is good to see my pastor. The angel of this house. The angel. Let me say this about the one thing I know about pastor is this. Nobody, not anybody's going to get in this pulpit. Not anybody. He interviewed me a series of times over the course of times, and he even compensated me for that. He kind of, you know, compensated me in such a way, but I am thankful to see him. He has vetted the process, and I know that the Spirit has spoke to him. And so I am thankful unto him. Unto the pastor, unto the first lady, to Reverend Brent McQueen, to all they that are assembled here today, grace and peace be unto you in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus, who is the Christ. Again, there's a sweet spirit in this church. I don't know how we can explain that which is unexplainable. God has his hand on it. I don't know why I drove down the street one day and took this right-hand turn into this church. And so that which is unexplainable, I know that God has his hand on it. And I thank you all for receiving and accepting me. How many know that some plant, others will put that seed in the ground, but it is God who gives the increase. And the higher that God elevates one, the more humble one must become. I'm thankful for all they that have been on this journey with me. You know, some 20 years ago, I was asked this question 20 plus years ago. It was asked of me, how is your relationship with Christ? Didn't have one. And I said, wow, that's an interesting thought. But it wasn't long after that. That my daughter would call and she would find me in church every day, and it was on noonday Bible study. She said, well, Dad, what are you doing there? What's going on? But not knowing that God had touched me in such a way. And I'm thankful for that question. I'm thankful for that question being presented, because it did make me think. It did make me think. And so, Gloria, there's my friend Gloria. There's my classmate Gloria. She's a new member's classmate. Gloria, just raise your hand a second. There's something about Gloria. I tell you, there's something about her. We praise you. We bless you. Bless you, Gloria. Bless you. I want to look at, and I know that we've been preached to today. What I want to do now is examine the Word of God. I know that Reverend Britt McQueen had preached to us earlier today, and we thank God for his message. You guys set me up. You put me up here behind him. I think you guys were trying to get to me, but certainly we are thankful unto him. Bless you. We want to look at a very familiar passage. One that we probably have known as children, and it is a psalm. What is the most familiar psalm that you know? The 23rd psalm. And so we just want to take a look at that. But prior to that, let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I stand here acknowledging that you are the way, the truth, and the life. Father, speak to me. Speak through me. Allow me to be a vessel. I'm thankful, Heavenly Father, for they that are gathered here today, for they that may be en route. Around them, surround them, hover over them, protect them as they travel to and fro. Father, let thy will be done. Let thy will be done. Nothing more, nothing less, and nothing else. Thank you for the opportunity to serve, to be here, to work with Pastor Jones. I thank you, Father. I thank you for all that you're doing and for all that you're going to do. We don't know what the future holds, but we know who holds the future. Yeah. And so we say, thank you, Lord. I say, thank you. I acknowledge you, and I I confess that I've made mistakes. Father, I got to say that I'm thankful for every experience that I have gone through, and that's the key. We go through. We don't have to stay there, but we go through. And so I thank you, Lord, right now. Have thy will be done. It is in the name of Jesus that I pray and say amen. 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 The 23rd Psalm, and it is our custom to stand on the Word of God. It is our custom to stand, so it may be, and I'm going to read the 23rd Psalm. The Word of God. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I may walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Please be seated. We in life, what I've come to realize and what I've come to find out is that we have choices. Sometimes our choices are correct and sometimes they're incorrect. And oftentimes, even in my choosing, I would look back and say, hey, if I could reverse that choice. But there are choices that we'll face every day. And we look at here, this psalmist, this writer, as he says that the Lord is, he's made a choice. He's proclaiming that the Lord is his shepherd. His shepherd. And so when we identify with a shepherd, we look at one who takes care of the flock. The shepherd of this house is Reverend William Jones. He takes care of the flock. He is the shepherd of this house. And so in our choices, every day, I have decided. I heard that song just not long ago. It says, I have decided to follow Jesus. There was a choice that was there. The decision was to follow Jesus. And so the question is, when I look at scripture personally, because let a man, let a person examine themselves. Don't look at anybody else, but let a person examine themselves. So when I look at scripture personally, how does this apply to me? How is it applicable to me? The Lord is my shepherd. I know that at one point in life, it hadn't always been like that, as I previously exclaimed, that I hadn't always had that relationship with Christ, but praise be to God. Praise be to God that he stepped into my life. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. As long as we got God, as long as we got God, as long as we got God, we don't need anything else. You know, we're all, oftentimes, we often try to find that next euphoric experience. You know, it may be in travel, it may be in a place of wherever, but if we have God, if you got God, that's all you need. That's all you need. You don't need anything else. And so he says here, I shall not want. And it's like this, as he leads him, he's leading this psalmist, he's leading he's leading this individual, this writer, he's leading him. And it's a journey. This journey that we're on, this imagery of motion, he leadeth me and he brings me to the still waters. And so, and all of it being said, this, we look at it and we have to identify that life is a journey. Who's leading us on that journey? Who's leading us? There's many voices in our heads, but which one? Which one is from God? How do I identify? How do we know? I hear these multiple voices in my head, but how do I know when it's God speaking? Well, I'm glad you asked. Let it, it has to line up with his word. It has to align with his word. If it's outside of his word, it isn't coming from God. We know that his word will stand, that the grass will wither, that the flowers will fall, but the word of God shall stand forever. And so we have to align it with his word. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. We go through things. You're going to go through things. As long as you got breath in your body, you're going to go through stuff. We're going to deal with stuff. But if we got God as our shepherd, he'll give us peace. He'll give us peace in the midst of a storm. Yeah. Not as the world giveth, because the world giveth, the world taketh away. But when God gives you that peace, you know that you know. Let not your heart be troubled. Well, why am I worried? Let not your heart be troubled, he says. Let not your heart be troubled. We don't need to worry ourselves with that, but we have to let go and let God. Let it go and let God deal with it. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He puts us, though we go through things, but he will restore it. You know, we have these programs, but he restores it. And he alone. He and he alone. We're going to go through things. But just remember this. We're just going through. You're not going to stay there. Life happens. Life's going to happen. It's not going to stay there. But now who do we become in times of challenge? When we have to go through something, who do we now become? Let not your heart be troubled, he said. He's got it. He's got it. But we have to learn how to let go and let God. You know, now we have to put our complete faith, and it is impossible, the word tells me, to please God without faith. You can't please him without faith. And so when we let it go and turn it over to him, he has it. Yea, though I may walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. I'm going through that challenging time. And it's not who we are in times of convenience and comfort. That's easy. Anybody can go through that. When it's convenient, when it's comfortable. But who now do we become in times of challenge? And so we look at these situations in the challenging times, and it can be very challenging, and especially if we don't have Christ. Especially if we don't have Christ. And so we thank God for his son. And it says here, for thou art with me, and thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table. Thou preparest the table before mine enemies. You don't, listen, you don't even have to worry. The battle is not yours. God's got it. The battle is God's. You don't have to worry. The battle is God's. He's got it. We're going to go through. But leave it up to him. Don't worry yourself. Don't stay up late at night. Don't concern yourself, because he says, if ye believe in me, if ye believe in me, and that's the thing. If you, it's all through the Bible. And if thou hast faith, and if you believe. So it's all throughout the Bible. But now what must we do? We must, 11:1, Hebrews, keep the faith. We have to keep the faith, even in going through. Keep the faith. Hold on. Hold on. Don't let go. And so the theme or the title to this message for me today, and I know that we tag it, we title it, you know, the message is, who is he? Who is he? And what is he to you? Who is he? And what is he to you? David, the psalmist, said that he is my shepherd. Who is he? He is my shepherd. He's leading me. Who is he to you? Some people might be the Prince of Peace, the Wonderful Counselor, the Alpha and the Omega, the Bright and Morning Star. Who is he? And what is he to you? And so we have to identify having that relationship. Do we just call on him in times of challenge? Do we call on him when we're in a situation? Do we have that constant communication with him? Or do we only call on him when situations arise? Who is he? Who is he? and what is he to you? Develop, nothing else, develop that relationship with him. Surely, 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 surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. Now, what do I have to do to have that to follow me? Wow. Well, I must be obedient. Obedient. The obedience happens. We have to be obedient to his word. And that's a challenge, because I can remember sometimes, and I'm just speaking about me. I ain't speaking about y'all. I can remember, I wanted to do what I wanted to do, Sister Young. I wanted to do what I wanted to do when I wanted to do it. I thought I was all of that. But you know what? Submitting to God's will, there's a joy with that. There's a joy to submitting. And sometimes, brothers, I got to say, this is kind of challenging for us. I mean, you know, to submit to his will. But what comes with that? What comes with that is a joy and a peace. And so I'm just thankful that that relationship has developed. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Paul put it this way. Paul said, hey, listen, y'all. To live is for Christ. If I'm going to live, it's going to be for Christ. To die is gain. But it is for your good, he said, that I'm here with you to share the word. But to live, he said, is going to be for Christ. And so we thank God. I thank God for the opportunity to stand here today. And I want to conclude. I know that we've been preached to, but I want to conclude today's message with the statement, who is he? Who is he? Who is he? And what is he to you? Bless your hearts. Bless your hearts. Thank you. Thank you.
Is he, and who is he to you? Very personal statement. Who is he?
And what?
What is he to you? Very, very powerful word. Did you know that God will lead, restore, comfort you? All that and a whole lot more. And then it gets personal. Understanding that your God is bigger than your situation. That's when you start self-examining yourself. To find out who is he. Thank you so much for allowing God to use you. Thank you for allowing God to take a hold of his word, put it in your heart so that we can receive it in a way that it makes sense to us. I cannot tell you exactly who he is to you, but to me, it's personal. Amen. Because when I think about the goodness of God and all that he has done, my soul,
yeah,
say hallelujah. So that he means something to me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Surely God had his hand in this message. And if you're listening, or you're here this evening, I always believe that when God's word has spoken, there should be an invitation. That if you're not in right standing with God, and if you have never accepted Jesus as your Lord and as your Savior, we should give you an opportunity to do so. So you might be listening over Zoom or on Facebook, or you're here this evening. If you have never trusted the Lord, the God who can restore, who can comfort, who can guide, the God that our dear brother talks about, if you have never accepted as your Lord and Savior, we beg with you to trust in Him. Or you might be here or listening, and you want your soul to be restored. You want to be in right standing with God. In other words, rededicate your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. We offer you nobody else than Jesus this evening. We could have been somewhere else this evening, but another opportunity for you to hear God's word. My Lord. We beckon you.
Yeah.
We plead with you. Make the decision before it's too late. God, we thank you. We praise you. We adore you for your word this evening.
Yeah.
God, I lift up your man servant before you. I pray for a special anointing upon him. That God, you would anoint him and loose him and let him go. That your gospel may reach, oh God, the lost souls. So hold him this evening, for it's in your son's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Now I'd invite the shepherd of this flock.
Bless him.
To make some remarks.
We prepare to resume our service. Will the deaconess as well as the deacons please come forward, please? Brother Fludd.
He's Lord.
He's right here beside me, my brother.
Okay.
Appreciate you, man.
Man, love you, man. Thank you, man. Thank
he
you.
Has
man.
Reason. Thank you, man.
Bless you, man.
And he's Lord.
That Jesus Christ is Lord.
One more time.
Lord, He is Lord. He has risen from death, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow.
Praise. Good afternoon to everybody. Thank you so much for being here today. Today is a very special day for Brother Fludd.
Amen.
And also for Far Heights Baptist Church. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I want to just say one or two words before we have the deacon and deaconess to pray for him. And as we pray for him, you can come forward if you like. And also we lay hands on him and pray for him as well.
Yes.
It's no doubt in my mind whether or not God has his hands on him and whether or not the word that he just preached was something that we needed to hear.
Amen.
Who is he? To you now.
Yes.
Not me. He said to you. But we all have to figure that out for ourselves, amen?
Yeah.
But the
yeah.
wonderful way to do that is through the God that we serve.
Amen.
None other can do that for us. Bless the Lord. I'm not going to carry you on like this. What I want to do is I want to be able to pray for my brother and thank God. And we know right now that there's no doubt in our hearts and minds that God wants you here with us. I thank God for that.
Amen.
I thank God for that. You bring a lot with you. God has already blessed you, and we're going to be led by you as well as the time goes by and the things that you do here at Forest Heights Baptist Church. That's what growth is all about.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
One at a time. There's one right there. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Okay, let's please come together. I'd like for us to lay hands on our brother.
Okay.
Yeah, everybody. Yeah.
Before we pray, scripture will be read, and it's going to be from Romans chapter 5.
Yes, Lord.
Starting out in verse 1.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into the grace wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Amen.
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 Let's pray for Brother Fludd.
Almighty God, we come humbly to you right now and thank you so much for the opportunity that you have given us here at Forest Heights Baptist Church to listen and hear this brother that you have called to preach your word, oh God. Brother Fludd, oh Heavenly Father, has not slept or slumber in his preparation to preach your word, oh God. So I thank you right now for that. And right now, oh God, I come to you humbly, and I thank you for his family that is here today in support of him as well, knowing that he is indeed called to do your word, oh God, and to preach and teach your word. He has already proven that to you, oh God, but now he's allowed us to hear him preach your word as well. Thank you, Father, in a very special way. Father, we are here at Forest Heights Baptist Church and looking forward to putting him to work doing your will, oh God. There's no question as to whether or not his abilities will be used here because he's a part of the family, Lord Jesus. He's a part of the body. And whatever it is, whether it's the hand, whether it's the foot, whether it's the finger, whether it's the toe, whatever it is that you've given him, God, I pray right now that you would bless him to be able to use it right here at Forest Heights Baptist Church. Thank you, Lord. Father, I thank you for his mom and dad, his family right now, oh God, for raising him in a way in which he would know the way to go. I believe in your word, oh God, that we will return and come back to you, Lord, if we get it in the beginning. Thank you, Lord. Who is he? It's the word. Who is he? Yes, sir. See, so that's what the question is. So, Father, we know right now that you've called him for Forest Heights Baptist Church, and we appreciate it, Heavenly Father. It just didn't happen overnight. Him and I have been working together for 3 years along with yourself, oh God. We've been talking and praying and making sure that we stay on track with your word, oh Lord. So now, Father, we place ourselves into thine hands, O Lord, that you would guide us and lead us as you would have us to go. Order our steps, my prayer is, O God. Let us not walk too far to the left or too far to the right. Let us stay on that narrow path of righteousness to do your will, O God. Father, we thank you right now for all that you have done and all that you do, O God. For it is in the precious name that we pray, O God. Let us say together, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
God be
Amen.
Praised. Ah, Amen. Yes, sir. God be praised. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Y'all come on and congratulate the brother. Y'all touch that brother. Sir.
Here
and then everybody as you go past, please stop and say a word.
I'm sorry.
Shake his hand, let him know.
I'm sorry, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Speak great. Speak great. Thank you, Mom. God is good. God is good.
Helped form the church.
Bless you.